So day two of Uncle Rob Yukon build. We actually have stuff to like do now, not just tearing down, we're actually gonna do stuff. Where is the Cooper pooper?
It is inside. I can escort you to the indoors.
Ooh, that's tight.
Maybe you need a 4-inch.
Yeah, that's, I believe that's,
ow!
Dang, Dale, I got the wrong one.
Dang it, Dale, I just cut my finger.
On what?
Fan blade.
Dang. It's
mighty sharp.
Dang.
Dadgummit.
Well, shoot. Think that speed shop around here would have any 4-inch couplers?
Probably.
Okay. My new shirt style showed up. I'll have them for sale at Cletus and Cars. Get them on the website once I get back to Texas, but check these out. Look at that. That's the money right there. Freaking sick. So I'm about to go to the parts store, among other places, and get all kinds of random stuff. While I'm doing that, they're gonna stay back here and get this manifold off. Today's list of critical tasks will be get the manifold off and flipped, get the intercooler mounted, make an intercooler to throttle body charge pipe, and start the crossover. A lot of it hinges on whether I'm able to find these parts, so I gotta get to it. We're gonna have to divide and conquer here, because there's just not enough time to have everybody go to the parts store. And how far away is that speed shop from here?
45 minutes.
Oh, great.
Yeah. Pretty sick. So, you need a coupler.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I don't think if I even have anything. I try not to use rubber.
Do you happen to have any small pipe? Like just little stubs?
Aluminum.
Of steel? Could be galvanized, aluminized, stainless. Just like, even if it's like 2 inches of it, just to stick the wastegate on here. Oh man, this is perfect.
This had been, look at all the times this had been messed with by the previous owner. Look at all like the aftermarket welds on the whole thing.
There's a screw in it.
Yeah. And look over here. This clamp is welded onto it.
Was this a stock V6 exhaust?
Yeah, it was stockly modified many times. It looks pretty strong to me.
Cole, are you a good Sawzall technician? Mm-hmm. Can you find a wastegate pipe in there? Mm-hmm. Remember, Cole's supposed to build the whole thing.
That's true, that's true.
Or should I ask you to do it and then you can tell him to do it? Chain of command.
He's gonna have to first figure out how to get this screw out. I wonder if that's welded in as well.
It might be friction welded.
I started to cut here, but then I realized, why am I even bothering?
I think
the whole thing came out of the Camaro when I just kicked it. I think it all fell.
I don't think you understand. This is the perfect type of garbage that we wanted to find.
I mean, you found it.
Cooper Speed Shop.
You found some garbage for sure.
All right, so now we got Boosted Boys old parts, JH old parts, Cooper's Camaro old parts.
There's even like an extra pipe in this pipe.
Oh, no way.
Yeah. Wall, that's for more PSIs.
Cole, there it is right here.
The inner one?
That's like literally the perfect inner diameter. Yeah. Cole, why don't you slice this off and then we'll get our wastegate pipe out of the center.
Do most people make their exhaust double layer like that? It's the first I've seen it.
It's a common factory thing, I think. I don't really know why. Someone could tell us why.
Makes no sense to me.
It's actually a little bit too small, but it's almost perfect. But it'll be fine for what we're doing. And the other side of it will make an actual, like, great kicker pipe. So we're mint right here.
Sending it.
That's all we need.
Dang.
This is turning.
It's actually turning?
Yeah. And it's half cut. Maybe that's the secret.
Just half cut to relieve some of that shoulder pressure?
Yeah.
For the people that are like, less talking, more working. Here we go. This is Verk.
It's turning.
It is.
I knew it. I hope.
Yeah, it wouldn't be turning that easy if it wasn't.
Mm-mm. Well, guys, my worst fear has been relieved thanks to Cole.
Header bolts are coming out with ease. Got the, or getting the header bolts out, which are surprisingly coming out a lot easier than we thought. We thought we were gonna have to cut off the heads or something so that they didn't break off, but with some heat and PB blaster, they are coming out. Exhaust manifold is out and all cleaned up. Now we can work on flipping it over.
Well, we brought in the master welder.
Yeah, I don't know
know about all that.
Mr. Tig, they call him.
On the stand until Mitchell gets back.
So you like the Bluetooth foot pedal more?
It is nice. Very nice, as opposed to the nothing else I've ever used. I've only ever used the Bluetooth. I probably won't even need to hold this thing. On the nut has like a coating.
Yeah.
TIG welders don't like coating, but it should work. Let's give this a try. Oh yeah. Enjoy making like expert welders cringe in the comments. Just because it really bugs them. They're like, oh, I would have came and done that for you. I'm up in Wisconsin, you should have just called me. Happens every time. I don't know why it's coming right through the ground. That's crazy.
It's like skipping.
May not be a good enough ground right there.
Yeah. Oh, we lost the nut.
Dang it.
Of course our one TIG welder's not here, Mitchell. Well, I really don't want to freaking break out the MIG welder because it's like a loss at that point, you know?
So, we got it. We can do it. We got it.
Yeah. Just have to.
Want to find another nut?
I can grab another one. I got plenty. Potentially solid.
Think it needs some rod?
It shouldn't. Yeah. Like a tack should be able to hold it.
Right.
If that was a good enough tack. Do we have those pliers?
I don't know exactly what this stuff is, but I'm gonna use it for mock-up purposes. Just tie it around the bolt, run it through here, pick it up, tie it around the other bolt, and that's gonna hang it. Adrian is clearancing the grill.
Yes, sir.
Cole's doing homework.
Yes, sir.
Because Cole is still in college. Still can't figure out what this is, but it's exactly what I needed.
I have no idea what it is. Like I said, I found it at like the dump. 8 years ago or something.
What are you working on here?
Fuel system stuff. All the fun.
It just occurred to me that we got a really good welder here. So I'm just gonna cut these, bend them into 90s and just run them right there and not even use these tabs that were already here. Just honestly, it'll be easier to do that. Is Loretta trying to take your spaghetti?
Where's my food?
Enjoy your macaroni chips.
And salsa.
Okay, yep. It's spaghetti. He's lying. He's actually eating spaghetti. But let's get this saw fired up here. Where's your best hit it with a hammer vise to bend these into 90s?
I only have the little baby vise.
Oh, well, that'll do. It's about on par with what I had back home.
Not very large, but it does work. Or you can put it on the anvil. Bend it like that with a hammer.
I'll just squish it in there and...
I mean, it should work.
Give her the old banging. This is far from secure, but I'm gonna hit it with a hammer anyways. Cool. Well, dang. Went a little too far. It helps if you hit it at kind of the tenon down here. But I think the vise will move if I do that, so I'm just going to smash it from the top and then unbend it the other way again. That one actually went a little bit better. Still messed up, but better. Wait, watch this.
Hey, where's that bug
spray? In the Tahoe? Yeah. No, too far, again. Almost. Missed him. Too much air. All right, well, I'm gonna get these cleaned up. By the way, that's the new shirt right there. That's actually the intercooler from the Escalade in that graphic with the pipes behind the grill and all that stuff. So you can get those on staplesandautoworks.com. Not yet, but they'll be there once we get back from Texas.
Definitely trimmed a lot more than I needed to.
But that's fine, because we're probably going to put a bigger one in there down the road anyway.
Yep.
What are you thinking, Turtle Man?
I was guessing you're going to have to put a bigger intercooler on that thing.
Unless it's got twin 69s for sure.
Yeah, for sure. But it'll work.
It'll work for now. This is probably cool. I don't know what Kyle's cars were making when they blew up, but...
420.
Is that what he said? Mm-hmm. 420.69?
Yep.
Ah. Right.
If it was an SR or KA, yeah, probably not all that much to blow up.
Fire up the old Fronius. It's cool now you got one. I don't have to bring mine.
Yeah, you just leave it at home.
It's the exact same thing. I'm about to weld these brackets on here.
I'll watch.
And Cooper's going to watch because he's... Has that machine ever done anything on aluminum before, ever?
Yes.
It has?
Yep. Kyle did. Kyle did it one time for me. He did some welding of aluminum.
Who's the boys, Kyle?
Yes. He's pretty good with welding, but he didn't really show me. He just kind of did it.
Oh.
Because he was kind of in like a rush and he had to go do stuff. And I was like, hey, just weld this on for me real quick type of deal.
Dang it, Kyle. All right. Well, we're going to show you today.
And a little bit of pointers here.
Yeah.
Settings and whatnot.
Yep, it's tacked a verified fitment, and now we're gonna run through it.
It was too cold. See how it was like not, it wasn't flowing quickly. It was kind of,
yeah.
And I was having to connect it with the rod. It should be hotter than that. And once I started freehanding it, I go. See how much better that was?
Yeah,
it's
a lot better.
It's like a flow.
Yep.
You don't put the rod in until you get the shiny puddle. Like you can start to see crap boil out of it, and then it gets real shiny. And that's when you do the rod. You think you could handle it?
I could probably give it a rip.
All right. Well, I'll turn it down so you don't have to move as quick.
I can hold it like that and have control.
Okay.
It definitely looks a little awkward,
it,
but...
It does. It looks like you're ready to fire up with some chopsticks or something. Start your puddle on the intercooler and then work the heat over to the piece. Well, we got that welded on there. Cooper had a good introduction.
A little introduction.
Introduction. I mean, you gotta start somewhere. Yeah. At least you saw how it was done.
I saw aluminum being welded at this point.
Yeah. Well, what happened to him was the.
And you were playing with the settings, which is.
Yeah.
Helpful.
He put the tungsten in there. He poked the rod into the tungsten, which got aluminum on the rod, which dirted up the whole puddle. So this section here was basically unrecoverable at that point.
Yeah, it's pretty rough looking. Pretty rough.
It's hard to learn when you're welding through crud. So, but after all this thrash is over, he's got some stuff to fix and we'll go through full welding school.
Once you have a turbo on your car for this weekend, which is not very far away.
It's not.
It's coming up quick.
Very quickly, and today is really the day that we actually started doing it. I thought we were going to start this on Sunday, but that did not happen. It never works like it's supposed to.
Nope. Alright, you're just going to send that thing in?
Oh yeah, we're just going to let it rip.
Just like, guesstimate, level and all that?
Oh no, I measured it as perfectly level, perfectly symmetrical.
Wow. Our tolerance of... You know, angles is 6.9 degrees.
It's fine because you have rubber couplers, so you can get away with a lot.
Yeah.
You good? Final position right there?
Yep.
Something like that.
That was way easier than I thought it was going
to be. Man, that thing's going to hold for at least the next
week.
6 to 8 weeks.
6 to 9 weeks.
Yeah, dude. Don't make the mistake of using one that's too long and poking through your AC condenser, because I've watched people do that before.
Yep.
It's not funny.
That is definitely pretty brutal to crack an AC condenser. I did that on my V1 at one point, and it was unfortunate. I should have just deleted it at that point. I don't know why I didn't.
We live and we learn, don't we?
It's like a sign.
You gotta get that thing back out on the road.
Someday.
Someday.
When all the stars align for it to be in the right way.
When my Monte Carlo's done, your V1 will be done.
No, your Monte Carlo will be done first.
Are you sure? It's been like 5 years. I still haven't done anything with it.
Yeah, but it'll still probably be done first.
I wouldn't be upset if it was. How's it going, Cole?
He's doing something.
I like how the smoke is coming out of the pipe.
Yeah, it's coming out of the exhaust.
That was from JH's mud truck. That's why it's blown out, because it's seen so much heat.
Are you guys cutting it so it's not divided anymore?
We're just harvesting the flange because the pipes that go into the flange are so much smaller than the ones we're using that it just makes more sense to start over.
Yeah.
And squish it down into
those pipes are tiny. Man.
Bang a coal.
Definitely could have gotten a flange.
Could have.
Definitely could have.
But it's not JH's flange.
That's true. Does that mean you're going to put this thing on its roof?
Oh, man.
It's got JH's
flange. Yeah.
Are we not going to park it in the Cletus pond? I'd really rather not do that.
Sounds kind of cool.
Not for this one. This thing is a family heirloom. I can't sink it. I'd do one more down at the bottom for that, but yep. Otherwise this thing.
I mean,
easy.
It is from the Boosted Boys, so.
And it's full of, from what I've been told, SR20 explosion. I don't know for sure, but a couple of you guys, when I said I don't know what this has been on, you said this intercooler was on that 240 when Kyle got it from Amelia as a roller, and he's blown up a couple SR20s in front of it.
Sounds about right.
That's just what I heard.
Yeah.
When I picked it up, a bunch of watery, oily goo came out of it. So.
The old Boosted Boys intercooler on there.
You might hear the ghost of an SR20.
Yeah. It's not a Honda, so you're fine.
You got Boosted Boys intercooler, JH flange, and the wastegate pipe will be from.
Back Camaro.
Yeah. The wastegate pipe will be
from
the original
fourth gen
V6
Camaro. That was a real race car in its day.
Fired up the old Fronius Magic Wave to do some welding stuff. To weld those dash 6 fittings to this oil cooler here. Just letting it ride. As you can see, I didn't clean any of this off or ground it, so it's like doing weird pops and bangs and stuff off the table. I'm gonna find some bolts to stick in here to have them sit on so it doesn't do that anymore before I start the other one. What do you guys say, Cole?
Suck it.
Good.
Just doing the fuel fitting still.
I was just waiting for you to say it. Guess not.
Not yet.
Right time.
Not
the right time.
Not the right time.
Not the right time.
They'll probably earn it this weekend.
So I just got those fittings welded up. That thing's ready to be mounted. I'm not gonna do that now though, because I know Adrian really wants to geek out about where to mount that thing. It's kind of like his baby. So I think me and Cole are gonna work on starting to figure out a merge setup for the T4 flange. I'm not sure what I got going on with this flange here, but my philosophy was to kind of like split it. Then when the crossover is made, I'll just run that up, and whoever this connects, I'll just run that pipe into it. So it won't merge at the flange, it'll merge before that. Then the wastegate will be a combined effort up front. We have some dog fighting going on here.
My seats are gonna be covered in dog hair. What kind of car, like, how many racing seats are covered with dog hair before you even put them in?
I got this little patch extension piece welded in. I'm gonna do the same thing to the other side.
Hey.
It ain't pretty, but it's gonna work. You know, see what I'm doing is I'll lay it down. I'll kind of get it a little bit bent up off of here, and I'll lay it down and I'll weld it where it's in full contact. And then see, for example, like I weld through here and then it'll start to get away from itself so I won't keep going. But the heat will make it so I can hammer it down. And then you weld a little bit, hammer it, weld, hammer. And then it eventually you can get the full wraparound just like this. Tech tip, learned that from Jeff Bless Jr. Heat is your friend in this instance. Weld it up, that's done. It's wicked hot, so I'm not gonna pick it up. I think we're starting to clean up now, because unlike most building situations where you would just bomb out until whatever, I gotta factor in the second half of my day, which is going back, importing, editing, uploading, publishing, thumbnail, all that stuff every day. That's part of it. This is how we survive.
We work the fastest this intercooler's ever gone.
I don't know, but this is about the most popular it's ever gonna be. Oh!
Oh, shots fired.
A couple SR20s blown up through it.
Yeah.
Well, geez, we're not that funny.
Our own stuff over here.
Well, I mean, I don't. I'm flattered, but I'm really not
that
funny.
She does the same
thing
to me. I'm like, oh man, that was really funny. And then I look over and she's like, just dying in her own world.
She's laughing at a meme or something.
Yeah, she's watching TikToks over here, not paying attention to anything else. Yeah. Oh, Bronzy.
Well.
This is ideal on a day-to-day basis.
This is what it's like. This is real life.
Yeah.
There's no secret threshold that gets crossed when you're like a YouTuber or something, or just,
oh, she's getting,
you know, it's just normal stuff.
I was more productive before I was posting videos. I'm sure you feel the same way.
Yeah, because now I gotta go back and edit stuff for 3 hours when I could just keep working.
That would be gross.
Yeah. No, I was more productive before.
Yeah. Hey. It's a bit of a double-edged sword because, you know, you feel like you're more productive, but cutting it short to make the videos continues to fuel the work that you are feeling like you're skipping out on.
But as a YouTuber, you want to share your day with the world.
Yeah.
And talk to the people and all that fun stuff. So you it don't want to just like do stuff and not show it because it's part of the fun.
Yeah, it is. Documenting the real life. This is what it is.
It's the Michael Vick cast over here.
I'm just saying, I've been, you know, dinking around with my friends in garages for, you know, 6 years now, and it's really not any different right now than it was back then, except I'm holding a camera on a stick.
And you get to have those memories forever.
Yeah. Really, I'm selfish, and I do these videos so I can watch them in 20 years and be like, hey, look what I was doing. This is my path.
Man, I hope I look back at these in 20 years and think, man, what was I thinking?
I hate
I'm sure I'll look at this and be like, damn, I didn't know what I was doing.
That's the beauty of it.
I look at stuff I did 2 weeks ago and think that. I'll come in tomorrow morning and think that.